Good morning, everyone. We're on a mission to improve people's lives, and this week we're addressing a number of top priorities. As the people's representatives in the House of Representatives, the Article 1 provisions are so important. That's how the people's voice is restored in our government. And I'm really excited that we're moving forward on important legislation that will restore the balance of power, that will bring back accountability, oversight, and appropriation of dollars, which is our Article 1 responsibilities. We're also going to wrap up the budget process and unlock tax reform. We've been waiting a long time for this moment, and this is our opportunity to unleash the potential of every person in this country. It means more jobs, fairer taxes, bigger paychecks. We are putting American families first, and we're really pleased that Carlos Cabello, representative out of Miami, is able to join us today, help put a face on this. He has a young family and representing many in this country that are going to be positively impacted. You think about just the amazing opportunities that it means for people. Coming from Eastern Washington, we have a lot of fourth and fifth generation family farms, small businesses. The elimination of the death tax means that those family farms will be able to continue. You think about a single parent trying to run a coffee shop and pay for childcare, the expansion of the child tax credit, full expensing. What the impact of that is on manufacturing companies that can buy an extra piece of equipment, expand their business, and create jobs. These are just some of the faces of tax reform. They're everyday, hardworking men and women all across this country that are many living paycheck to paycheck, and we want to help with reduce that burden, the cost of living, on so that they have more of their dollars in their own pocketbook. So along the way, we're going to be giving you all of the details. We're setting up a text messaging that I know you're all going to want to join. All you got to do is text tax reform to 50589 and you'll get the latest and greatest. Carlos Cabello.
Thank you so much, Kathy, for inviting me to be a part of this press conference this morning and to talk about the most important thing that Congress can do for the American people, which is to pass meaningful tax reduction for every American family, to overhaul the tax codes so that American companies stop leaving the United States and instead invest more here in American infrastructure and in American families. This is about all of those people who haven't benefited from the economic recovery. We've had a long recovery in this country, and it's been very good for people, especially people at the top. But what we want is for the economic recovery to reach every household in our country. People who are frustrated, people who feel like they've done everything right, but they still can't get ahead. Young people who have gone to college, invested in a degree, and still don't have a quality job. This is about them. This is about thousands of immigrant families in my district who came to this country with a willingness to work, who love this country as much as anyone else does, yet they're not getting ahead. So I'm so excited that we are officially kicking off this process here very soon in the Ways and Means Committee, that we're going to put a product out there that every American is going to be able to see is going to improve quality of life in this country. And lastly, I'll say, this isn't just about taxes and about the economy. This is about us showing that Congress can work together to improve the lives of every American. This is about restoring the faith, the trust, the confidence in our government, which is something we sorely need in this country. So thank you, Kathy, and to the rest of our leaders.
Steve. Great job, Carlos. Thank you for joining us here today. We're talking about cutting taxes for American families. And that process starts this week by passing our budget. So we're going to move the budget this week so that we can truly start the process of cutting taxes across the board. And what does that mean to American families? What we've seen over the last decade is an erosion of our middle class. We've all seen big companies moving thousands of jobs overseas, and we've complained about it. We don't like it. Well, now we're going to do something about it. Our tax cut plan not only benefits the middle class, it allows us to rebuild the middle class by bringing those jobs back to America. Let's be competitive again. And it's real easy to do, and for whatever reason, you've got some people on the other side that want to keep tax rates high. We don't want to have the highest corporate tax rate in the world. We don't want to keep seeing jobs move overseas, so we're going to do something about it with our tax cut plan. And that plan not only rebuilds the middle class, but it actually puts more money in the pockets of families. The Council of Economic Advisors just came out with a study last week of our tax cut plan, and what it shows is this, that for the average American family, they're going to see $4,000 per year more in their paycheck. Now, what does that mean, having $4,000 more because we cut taxes for families? That means they can add on to their house. They can buy a new house. They can buy a new car. They can go on a family vacation. This is something that's going to help benefit the middle class. And what it also means is simplicity in the tax code. Everybody knows our tax code is too complicated. In fact, most families have to hire somebody to do their taxes. Under our plan, you'll actually be able to do your taxes on a postcard. Over 90% of American families under our tax cut plan not only will get $4,000 on average more per paycheck, they're going to actually be able to do their taxes on a postcard. Tax simplicity. Let's rebuild the middle class. Let's bring those jobs back from overseas, back to America. Let's pass this budget and start tax reform.
As you heard from the other speakers, the importance of tax cuts. What does that actually mean when you say tax cuts? Currently, if you're a single individual in America, the first $6,000 you make is tax-free. When our bill passes, that'll be increased to $12,000, doubled. But if you're a family, a couple, now you only get $12,000 tax-free. After our bill passes, it'll be $24,000. As Steve talked about, instead of spending weeks filling out your taxes, you will spend minutes. Instead of America starting behind the starting line with the rest of the world, with the highest corporate rate, we'll now be competitive. Instead of a tax code that punishes American businesses that are successful around the world, makes them keep their money in other countries, we'll change that where they bring it back home and invest in America. Now, many of you know I started my first small business when I was 20 years old. Small business creates more jobs in America than any corporation. We are going to lower the rate to the lowest it's been in 80 years. We are going to unshackle what's been holding this country back with an opportunity of growth for all. It's simple, it's fair, it makes us competitive. Now I just hope the Democrat leadership won't hold back their members. Give them the freedom to vote for what is right. There are other things we're taking up this week as well. As you notice, we'll have two sanction bills on the floor dealing with Iran and North Korea. I do want it noted that the North Korean sanction legislation, we have changed the name. We're going to honor Otto Warmbier, a 22-year-old University of Virginia student who was brutalized and tortured by the Kim regime. We'll take that vote up today. Now, when we take the budget up on Thursday, that will speed up tax reform by 2 weeks. That is the second phase as we move into tax reform. First, our budget, now getting to reconciliation. We are committed to get this done. It has been too long and too many decades. America needs this. And as many as you go home tonight, you will hopefully watch the first game of the World Series. And it has been too many decades since the Dodgers have won. So go Dodgers.
I'm not going to comment on the last one. As was said, by completing this budget, that is one big step closer toward historic tax reform, which means we're one big step closer toward a pay raise for middle-income families, for hardworking taxpayers. That is who this thing is all about. It is about the people. You got to remember, more than half the people in this country are living paycheck to paycheck. And then a lot more people are living one paycheck away from living paycheck to paycheck. That is what's happening in this country. So it's about these people who are struggling to get by. It's about giving those families a real break on their taxes so that you get to keep more of your own money in the first place. It's about making this system simpler and fairer, removing the hassles and the headaches to the point you can do your taxes on the form the size of the postcard, which Steve-O just showed you. Because all that time and money that Americans spend during their taxes, that is time and money that could be better spent on other things that are important to families. In addition to all of that, we are going to help workers in a big way by leveling the playing field for American businesses, big and small. What that's going to do, it's going to help bring back jobs and capital that have gone overseas. So it is no surprise that we've already seen a number of estimates showing that this alone is going to mean more take-home pay for families, higher wages, bigger paychecks. Helping middle-income people isn't just the goal of this plan, it's the whole purpose of this plan. So adopting this budget is another sign of real momentum for tax reform, of getting the train on the tracks and getting this moving so we can deliver real tax relief and a healthier, stronger economy for the American people. I want to thank President Trump for his leadership. I want to thank him for expressing to our members just how urgent this is for the country and how needed this is for workers. As he said, we are on the verge of doing something very historic. We are on the verge of doing something that is going to make a big difference for so many families, and that is why we're excited about getting this budget moving this week and moving on to tax reform. Questions? So you're going to ask a question not related to tax reform, right? Yeah.
The president is coming up here to
bring
some of your colleagues in the Senate, supposed to be talking about tax reform, but much of this morning is the back and forth of further escalation of dispute with Senator Porter. What do that do to your efforts in tax reform if the president can't stay focused?
I don't think it changes our efforts on tax reform. I know Bob, who supported the budget, wants to get tax reform. I know the president wants to get tax reform. I'm glad the president's coming to lunch, because I long believe that it's best is to settle these things in person, and I hope that they can get a chance to do that. Sherman.
When you guys ran, we're getting up on a midterm, last time in 2016, you traveled a lot saying Republicans should get the keys to the government because we're responsible, somber, sober leaders of government. And the president's, you know, saying the guy can't get elected dog catcher. Corker's calling him a liar. Like, what should voters think about this going into the midterm elections?
What they should think about are the results we achieve for the American people.
So ignore everything else.
So, you know what we're focused on? What's within our control. And what's within our control here in Congress is getting stuff done for the American people and getting a healthier economy, bigger paychecks, more take-home pay. That, to me, is what's important. At the end of the day, I know Bob well. Bob's going to vote for Tennessee. He's going to vote for America. He's going to vote for tax reform because he knows it's in the best interest of Americans. So put this Twitter dispute aside. The fact is we have a historic chance of actually fixing this tax code, giving people pay raises, and getting the American economy growing at the rate where we can actually get bigger paychecks, more take-home pay, a healthier economy. That's what matters. So all this stuff you see on a daily basis on Twitter this and Twitter that, forget about it. Let's focus on helping people, improving people's lives, and doing the things that we said we would do that accomplishes that. That's what we're focused on. You can ask about this, or
I'm tax reform.
All right, good.
Yeah, I'm subjecting to proposed pay fors. How do you plan to lower rates without any pay fors?
I would love to answer that question because that's what the Ways and Means Committee chairman does. But I'm going to have to defer you to Kevin Brady, the Ways and Means Committee. They're the ones who hold the pen on this thing. They're the ones who are negotiating this bill, writing this bill. So all these questions will be answered very shortly when the Ways and Means Committee puts out their mark. But if you have any specific questions you want to ask about it, I would encourage you to ask the Ways and Means Committee because this is their jurisdiction.
Last question.
Are we on track to finish this by deer hunting season, the Saturday before
deer
season?
Yeah, in the House, yes.
In the
so
house.
There's different
house
deer
boat.
Seasons. There's bow season, there's gun
but
season, there's muzzleloader season. So, you see with a beard, you'll know when the season is. No, so... we get this done by Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving week is opening week of gun season. So our goal is to get it out of the House by then. The Senate's going to be a little slower on their track because, as you know, tax goes first in the House. That's the Constitution. By muzzleloader season, I can't remember exactly when muzzleloader season. Let me check with the Wisconsin muzzleloader season. I usually just do bow in December. So our goal is to get it done by the end of this year.
I thought you were giving it up if that's what it meant.
That's right. We'll give up Christmas if we had to. Actually, that's what I said before. You're going to quote me on that, aren't you? I'm just joking. We're going to get this done. Yeah, look at Casey. Yeah, you guys are going to. You're staying here with us, too. Yeah.
No, just kidding. Look, and so, reconcile differences between the Senate and House version in December?
That's what conference committees are all about. Yeah. Thank you, everybody. Appreciate that.
We're all Okay.